Catching spring Chinook is all about giving them what they want, then getting them on the hook. Now here's Phil Pirone with a highly effective bait rigging technique.
I want to show you a couple of great ways to rig your baits so that you stop missing short biters. You'll get driven nuts with short biters. You'll look at your bait and you'll say, how can these fish possibly miss these hooks? They do. And I'll show you a way to really cut down your missed fish by about 70, 80, 90%, and you'll love it. Normally when I set my distance, my spacing, I'll actually take one of my baits because they vary in size. I know that's where my top hook's going to be, and normally I want my bottom hook to be right about there on the tail, right about the notch of the tail. So I will go ahead, and normally I don't use fluorescent material for leaders, but I was hoping you'd get a little bit better view and be able to see a little bit more clearly. I go around that about 7 or 8 times, and again, I usually run my leaders about 6 feet long, but for the purpose of our little seminar here, I cut it a lot shorter. I go through the eye of the hook, and then 4 or 5 more times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 around, hold that with my finger, wet my monofilament, and then pull it up like that, and I usually stick it on a plier handle or a scissor handle and pull it up tight. That's a standard rig right there for rigging up a herring. And I'll take my Procure killer cutter, lay my herring in like this, and if you want a great knife that never wears out, it's this little Forstner wavy blade 3-inch knife with a red handle. If you can't find it, Procure sells it. Go online and check us out. All right, I've got my bait ready to run my hooks through. Now this is a standard rig. I'm going to show you why so many people miss fish. I come through the tall side like this, or the right side of the bait. I pull my hook through gently. Then I take this, and this is what's going to set your roll. Now what you want to do is you want to come in, if you look right there, and that is the spine of the fish, I take my hook and I come in on the left side, and at an angle I come through, I come out the right side. Now that hook is through the spine of the bait, and that's going to set your roll. And here's where your problem is. You can let this hook dangle like this, but what happens is centrifugal force. As your bait rolls really quickly, this hook is spun out like this. So your bait's rolling in a 1-inch circle, and your hook's running in a 6 to 8 inch circle. So a lot of times when your bait's spinning really fast, here's where your hook is. A fish comes in this way, yeah, he's going to get bit. But from the tail nippers or from the other side, if your hook's over here spinning, you're not going to get bit. The next evolution was to take this hook and bury it near the tail, like this, come through the meat like that, and stick it on like that, okay? And you still get the same roll, and now if a fish comes up from the tail, he gets it. But it still doesn't protect your tail nippers. Those little tail nippers come in, they grab your bait right there, and they tear it up, one hit like this, and what happens to your bait is, it's like that, it doesn't roll anymore, and you missed your fish. It's done. One hit, it's gone. So, 2 things for this new way to do it. The first change is you're going to need more distance between your hooks. So if you take this as your average bait, and this would be my average distance for this green label bait right here, you're going to need more space like this, okay? And you might look at that and say, that's way too long, but trust me guys, it's not going to be. The second major change is we're going to go through this tail meat that's very shallow, and you cannot have this tag here at all. This little tag right here, if you can see that, that little tag right there will tear your bait up. And the only way you can get it is either with a razor blade or to use your little knife like this and take it off as close as you can get it, just like that. So there's no tag showing at all, none at all. Check your knot, make sure you haven't clipped your wrap if you want it to come undone. So with that tag clip short and more space between your hooks, we're going to show you the coolest way to not get taken by short biters, to get 80 or 90% more of your bites landed. Come through on this side, go through the spine, come out like that. That's going to give you a great tight roll. And then what we're going to do now, which is real different and why you don't want that tag, is we're going to pass this hook through this very little piece of tail meat here. You got to feel it run right along the spine, so you gently roll it through like this. And then when you come to here, slide it down like that and gently wiggle it through your bait without tearing up. If you had your tag there, that would have torn your bait up. Now what's going to happen is when this bait rolls, no matter how fast it rolls, this hook's right in line. There's no place a fish can come in on this bait and not get hooked. If he comes in from here, he's getting hooked. He's going to get hooked no matter where he comes in. Now there's another little trick if you want a faster roll. Cut down a resistance. And how do you cut down a resistance? Real simple. We call this our hyper roll. And normally I would clip this before I put my hooks on, but you just take your tail and you clip it like that. Now you've cut down your resistance. And this tail, this spin gets about 20% faster with the tail clip like that. And the salmon aren't smart enough to figure out the tail's missing. They're just looking at this big fat piece of meat. That's all they want, and it works great. But again, when you do it this way, you've only got a small piece of meat to get that hook through. If that tag's out there, it's gonna rip your bait every single time. So again, clip that tail, that tag really close, and come through this way. You can have it a little bit shorter if you want. It could be actually that short if you want, but right where that is isn't bad for the tail nippers. They come in and nip that tail, they're gonna get hooked.